Ocohalito, how y'all doing? It is rrjxitips.com. Get at me for your spirit astrology or life path sessions, readings, consultations. All right. Or rjxitips.com. So it is the season of the ancestors. And you know that my family is indigenous and Creole. Okay. I have the Creole, which is the French mixed in there, and then the Criollos, the Spanish mixed in there. All right. So this is why I embrace and celebrate the Day of the Dead, whether it's Fête Gaidée, which is the French Creole one, the Taino people of Haiti, they did come and mix with some of the Louisiana Creoles. Now, y'all know that the Orleans port was like a major center where peoples came through there. And y'all know that New Orleans is like a big pot of gumbo, Louisiana, period. Now, my mother's side, my maternal side, is from Louisiana and South Carolina. All right. My father's side is also from South Carolina, Mississippi, southeastern of the US, right? So, y'all know I celebrate Day of the Dead. It's also Indigenous Peoples Heritage Month. All right, American Indian Heritage Month. So, I'm gonna be doing a video with, tips and a lot of wisdom and information on that. But this is November 3rd. This is the last day of the Day of the Dead. Fête Gaidée, Día de los Muertos. Okay, we have altars in our homes and we have offerings. Everything on our altar represents the five elements: spirit, which is the creatress, creator, source of all things. All right, you got air, you got the incense with the smoke and vapor. That's the air. And then the incense also is things from the earth. All right. And then the fire. All right. And then you have some fucking liquor, some libations for your ancestors and loved ones. You have some liquor or you have some water. I put rose water on there. Sometimes I flavor it with different things. I have whatever I got in my bar or their favorite drinks. Now, the French Creole love rum, especially Haiti, Haitian, Taino rum, okay? And then the Criollos in my bloodline, they prefer tequila. Actually, Pukke, which is from the same Maguey plant, okay? You have Pukke, which is for sacred inebriation. And then you have tequila and mezcal for, if you want to have a little drink, celebratory drink. All right. So that's what I got in my cup. Some tequila. All right. So cheers to my powerful Indigenous and Criollos ancestors and loved ones. I love you. Cheers. All right. Pour y'all out some liquor. So pour out a little liquor for your ancestors. I already got my lime and my salt in there. I'm ready. She ready. All right. So now I have three different decks that I use around this time because I do specials around this time, y'all. I do specials. And you got the Santa Muerte deck. These are oracle cards. Our ancestors used things from the earth, whether it was sacred bones, sacred rocks, sacred crystals, sacred stones, you name it, leaves, cards. They used a lot. I do have a video on my YouTube about the different methods of divination that our ancestors used. They just was tapping into great mystery, the mother, great spirit, the father, source of all things. Okay. They was just tapping into that energy with the different aspects, the elements of the earth. They use that to get messages from the spirit realm. Okay. So y'all don't gotta be scared. Okay. So the other deck is the Toltec deck. All right. This is the ancient Xi, the Shi, the Omek, the Tamo'ankin, who passed down their knowledge to the Toltec, all right? Seekers of knowledge. Seekers of knowledge, wisdom keepers, fire keepers, all right? The bearers of knowledge and truth. And then, yeah, no, I got the New Orleans Voodoo Tarot. So if y'all want to tap into that special, October and November is when I do specials, okay? When I do specials for the Day of the Dead specials. Fete Gede, French Creole, and Dia de los Muertos, the Criollos, all right? Because, yes, the dark Spanish and some of the light-skinned Spanish mixed in with our people. And the light-skinned French. The dark-skinned French mixed in with our people. So, anyway. So, I'm going to pull up a couple of cards. But I did want to do... Now, this is the Toltec Oracle, right? These are patterned after hieroglyphs, codices... of that are actually on like the temple or El Castillo, the pyramid of Kukulcan, Quetzalcoatl. These things are carved and painted on the walls. So these cards are a mirror image of that. Now this card represents my horoscope. Mesoamerican zodiac. Sib is it, but this is the vulture. Cascacolotli. Cascacolotli. All right, the vulture. And Sib is CIB. Look that shit up. The sacred vulture, the shaman, the truth seeker. All right, this is a depiction of the great El Castillo, the temple, the pyramid of Kukulcan, Quetzalcoatl, all right? That is like the, in all societies, there is a messiah figure, all right? An ascended master that, you know, shared truth and wisdom with the peoples. But first, there was a mother that taught the tribes everything. How to pray, how to cook, how to get things from the earth. All that. The mother, the great mother, nurtured and taught the people that. And then later, you have the offspring of the mother, which is also a feminine aspect. And then this is the masculine aspect. Like the Quetzalcoatl's, Kukulcan's, all that, right? So this is me on top of the pyramid of Kukulcan. And this is affirmations and communication with great mystery, great spirit. That's what that is. Got my gear. This is the vulture, which represents the shaman. That can tap into the spiritual realm and remain balanced because we on the earth plane, which is the middle realm. So you got the underworld, the middle world is earth, and then the heavenly realms, the cosmos, that is the spiritual world, okay? And so the shaman can tap into either or, all right, and still be balanced on the earth realm. So these cards are patterned after that. So now this is the Santa Muerte deck because it is Day of the Dead. All right. Now, this deck, I like this deck because it does give some guidance from the ancestors, right? This is how the cards look. All right. And okay, these are your ancestors. All right. They judging. They giving you guidance and wisdom, all right, around this time when you communicate with them. All right. When you communicate with them, all right. Now, this is kind of like a yes, they're not here physically, but in essence, they are getting up out of the grave to communicate with us. They live in our hearts. They are connected to us through our blood, our bloodline. We have a connection with our ancestors, okay? So this card also represents being born again. All right. We go through different cycles and stages in our life and where we are reborn, rebirthed. All right. As always, birth, death, resurrection, rebirth. The cycle continues, all right? And in this deck, you have, they tell you the meaning of it, and then they tell you advice from the dead, all right? So I like this deck, all right? Now, these are just visual things to tap into the messages. I am a spiritual messenger, all right? A shining one, an oracle. All right. So, an Ani Dohi, I am a messenger, a spiritual messenger. So, we're going to dig into some cards. And then we have the New Orleans Voodoo Tarot. All right. Now, you got the Santos, the saints, because our ancestors had to conceal their spirituality and culture. So a lot of saints are at the forefront, but behind that is some Caboclos. Those are indigenous spirits, or the Loas, indigenous Creole spirits, or the Orishas, Aboriginal spirits, Diasporan spirits. Okay. Now this is what they look like. That's a veve, which is a symbol, all right? Now, all right, so this will be another description of what I am, which is like a mambo, okay? A spiritual messenger. People go to the mambos to get spiritual messages from the ancestors, the spiritual realm. All right, they have all these different words, wordplay, all that, okay? So you don't gotta be scared because the Loas, the Orishas, the Caboclos are just aspects of Great Mother, Great Mystery, and Great Spirit, Great Father, source of all things. All right, they personify different aspects of the Mother and the Father, source of all things. And the elements and the herbs and the roots are represented because the herbs and the roots can be used for healing, medicine, and they can also be used for poison. In everything, there's balance. There's a good and bad, and then there's a middle lane. All right, which is balance. It's a time for everything. So now this is a depiction of the Gede, the dead, of Fet Gede, Dia de los Muertos. Okay, you have the skull. This is like from the Criollos, the Dia de los Muertos. And then this is from the Taino Haitian voodoo. All right, Creole spirituality, the Gede. So you got Muertos and the Gede. All right. It's just one is using Spanish mixed with indigenous words. The other one is using French mixed with indigenous words. Okay, that's what it is. All right, now this is the gatekeeper in a lot of spirituality systems. If they're balanced, they have a feminine aspect and a male aspect. They have a pair. It's always feminine and masculine, complementing each other. So this is Papa Gede, or some would liken him to Baron Samedi, Papa Legba, but Baron Samedi has a counterpart, has a feminine aspect. That is Mama Brigitte. You also have Exu, EXU or ESHU. Exu has Pambajira, Maria of Seven Crossroads. They guard the cemeteries where the dead is buried. All right. All right. So this is just a little overview. I'm gonna put some cards, but I just wanted to try out this little StreamYard. I've been saying I was gonna do it, but today is the day. So I meant to do it. Today is November 3rd. So this also ties into All Saints Day and All Souls Day, okay? I told y'all the saints are just a cover. The saints, the santos, they're just a cover for the caboclos, the loas, the orishas, which are personified spiritual aspects of the source of all things, the mother, the feminine aspect, and the father, the masculine aspect. So this will be an aspect of, okay, Marasa. This is feminine and masculine. They complement each other. This is balance. This is balance. Okay? So and shout out to Marie Laveau, that Louisiana Creole. So we also have Mardi Gras, which is representing our ancestors, like a Day of the Dead live celebration. All right. It's where we just celebrate the fleshly pleasures, and our ancestors visit, like, okay, like Maman Brigitte and Baron Samedi. They like to mount people and embellish in the earthly pleasures. Okay. When I say mount people, like in Christianity, when they say, oh, you're getting filled with the Holy Spirit, this is something that they got from our indigenous ancestors, where the spirit, which the spirit is already within you, is just activated. It's just turned the fuck up. And you have this Kundalini awakening, all right, where you are open to receive these spiritual messages from the spiritual realm that's getting mounted or getting filled with the Holy Spirit, okay? Now, Marie Laveau, y'all know she is one of the most revered voodoo priestesses of Louisiana, New Orleans, Louisiana, okay? Dr. John is her counterpart in here. But it's always balanced, okay? Like, now in this deck, which is the New Orleans Voodoo Tarot, all right, this is Papa Gede and Maman Brigitte. This is a divine couple that's over the dead. They are like the caretakers of the dead. In some aspects, different spirituality systems, they have mediators. But understand, you don't need a mediator. Because you got the same blood running through your veins as your ancestors. So you have a direct link to them. Now, your deceased loved ones, now you could tap into a mediator for communication with them. But your ancestors, with great source, mother and father, source of all things, you got a direct communication, direct line. Your ancestors, you got a direct line of communication. But your loved ones and other people, there's the mediators, okay? You got Papa Gede and Mama Brigitte, okay? You got Baron Samedi, Papa Gede, Ishu, Papa Legba. These are the gatekeepers, all right? They are Maria Seven Crossroads with Ishu, okay? They guard the cemeteries. They guard the sacred dead, all right? They guard basically the bodies and then the spiritual realm. And they represent a balance of masculine and feminine energy, okay? But I'm going to find Marie Laveau, her counterpart in this deck, because it represents the feminine aspect and the masculine aspect. This is how you have balance. If your spirituality system or your religion does not have a mother, goddess, creatress, source of all things, and a father, god, source of all things, they don't have balance, your religion, your spirituality is not balanced. It's either, it's not balanced. But this is kind of like a little educational thing, and I'm just sharing that I am doing specials, all right? And this is what I was talking about, kind of like being filled with this Holy Spirit or being mounted. And they say, this is the master of your head. Okay, it's different aspects of great mother, goddess, creatress, and different aspects of father, creator aspects, okay? Warrior, warrioress, nurturer, guider, you know, different aspects. So different aspects of mother or father is personified. And so a person is like, this is like, okay, you're a spirit guide. Like the average person has at minimum 5 spirit guides. Okay. They could be animal totems, animal spirits, people, your spirit guides, ancestors, loved ones. I'm having a hot flash. And I flat iron my hair. My hair is sweating it out. But anyway. But this is a depiction of your spirit guide that directly works with you. The average person has at least 5. 9 is like for every direction all around you. You have spirit guides that work with you. All right. And my indigenous is animal spirits. All right. And then in my Creole is different. Loas, Caboclos, Orishas. Okay. So, I need to turn the heat down. It was really cold, but now it's all hot outside, which is freaking crazy. This is another depiction of the spirit helping this woman, giving her wisdom, guidance. It's just a depiction of it. Oh my God. I want to turn go get up and turn the heat off. But anyway, so if you get a spirit astrology reading from me, spirit astrology deals with your indigenous Creole and modern like astrology, zodiac, all of that. All right. Your animal totems, your spirit guides and guidance, all of that. And then a life path session deals with, just guidance, a counsel session. I may use oracle cards. I may just tune in to the spiritual realm and just give you messages. I may use a specific deck. I just flow with the spirit, okay? And I'm here for those that you haven't really acknowledged or developed your spiritual communication direct line with Source, Creatress, Creator of all things, and your spirit guides and animal totems, all that. You have not like really delved deep and tapped into it. So I am here to help you tap into that. So if you want that, go to my website, rrjxitips.com. And that card that I showed you at first, the Mambo card, it's just a depiction of a person that is in tuned spiritually. And that snake, that is just your kundalini, your life force, powerful energy, a connection to great mystery, great spirit within you that rises up your spine and it activates your first eye, which is your pineal gland, your first eye. They call it your third eye. So that picture was just a depiction of that. So you don't have to be scared. Our ancestors used different animals and different symbols, different things to communicate, to leave messages and clues to help us on our life's journey. Because the goal is to become an ascended master. Now, this is your ancestors. So, around this time, this is the last day, All Saints Day, All Souls Day, Day of the Dead. This is the last day, November 3rd. All right. So, but this is where I do like specific readings dealing with these three decks, okay? The Santa Muerte deck, Santa Muerte Tarot, the New Orleans Voodoo Tarot, or the Toltec Oracle. Now, the Toltec Oracle, we're gonna put that aside because that is one of the decks that I use for your spirit astrology reading, if you want to go deep on that. But, okay, yeah, Dr. John and Marie Laveau are counterparts in this deck. He played the drums to like set the atmosphere, the frequency of the drums, called in the spiritual realm. It just like welcomed the spiritual realm to where they were when they had those days when they were at Congo Square and they could freely practice their spirituality and culture out in the open in Congo Square. He was like a hoodoo doctor. He dealt with herbs and roots, and he was playing the drums to summon the spiritual realm. She tapped into the spiritual realm because she was a voodoo priestess, a high priestess. She delved in herbs, roots, and being a messenger. All right, she also did hair. But herbs and roots, and she did give people messages and guidance and tools to help them in life. All right, this is a bat a balance of masculine and feminine. But this is just my little first StreamYard video. And Olodumare is a depiction of great spirit, great mystery, all in one. The mother and the father are one. Olodumare, okay. And that's Papa Legbug, the gatekeeper of the dead, the sacred dead, your loved ones, who we are celebrating at this time. Ooh, my hair just sweated out. Whew, okay. All right, I'm gonna show y'all one more. And these are the wild, this is the wild card, okay? Les Barons, okay? The Barons, like, these are, like, okay. So November 1st and 2nd is, like, the festival of the Feast of Our Ancestors. You have the babies. You have everybody else, your ancestors, your loved ones that passed away. And then the third day is for the ones that nobody remembers. And I got on my Coco shirt. All right. One night only, live in the land of the dead. And y'all should watch Coco and, of course, the Book of Life. If y'all don't got that, I got them. So this is a good little movie night for y'all and the kids, the children. Rather. I was trying to find that. But yeah, so this, I'm just giving y'all an overview. But these are the ones that nobody remembers. Like, the ones that y'all didn't set up no altar for them. Y'all didn't, like, have a shelf with their picture and their favorite things or something that they had. Like, some people have their necklaces, their wallets, a piece of their hair, their favorite mug, their favorite shot glass, you know, shit like that. The ones that y'all don't remember, they are still getting love on November 3rd, the third day. Okay? So it's all about honoring your ancestors. And then when the invaders came, they really demonized us honoring our ancestors and dead loved ones. They want to demonize our shit and force their shit on us. Tequila ain't no joke, baby. This is like a depiction of the underworld. Les Morts. Les Morts. Okay, so a Santero, a Mambo, these are spiritual practitioners that you go to that help you. If y'all watched Queen of the South, when they went to New Orleans, Pote went and got with Santeria, voodoo, you know, to get protection and cleansing for himself and Teresa. So, okay, check that out. Yeah, so this is just, okay, so this is the last, that this is that picture that I was showing. This represents This Mambo is one with the spirit realm. She is tuned in. She is tapped the fuck in. And she can give you messages. All right. This is like kind of like the prophetess or prophet of the church. All right. But this is on a whole nother level because it's free. It's not bound to religious restrictions like Abrahamic religions. But yeah, and then this is so y'all won't be scared of the snake. The serpent represents wisdom. It represents your that great spirit within you, great mystery within you, your life force, that spark that's like electricity, and it moves. And the physical depiction that can describe that is a snake. How you see the snake moving. So our ancestors use different things to communicate with us and show the similarities, okay? This is what they did. So this is the feminine aspect. This is the masculine aspect. All right. Aida Wado and Dambala Wado. You also have good sides of the spirits, and you got the evil sides of the spirit, and then you got the ones that's like treading the middle lane. So this is kind of like a cooler, more balanced. And then you got the petrol. That's the fire. That's more like the I won't say negative or totally evil, but it could either be powerful, potent energy, or it could be evil energy. You choose who you work with. All right. You choose who you work with. And every spirituality system of the ones that I embrace of my ancestors, there is good, evil, and then there's balance because it's a time for everything. And everything is balanced. There's a feminine aspect, a mother aspect, and then you have a masculine, a father aspect. So if y'all want, today is November 3rd. This is the day where we remember the ones that are not remembered, like they ancestors didn't set up no altar for them, didn't pour out no liquor for them, didn't fix them a plate. They the wild card. They kind of like, I won't say orphans, but they the wild card. Right. So, if y'all have any questions, just get at me. This is at 38 minutes. So, let's pull one card from the New Orleans Voodoo. Just an overall general message. I kind of broke some shit down for y'all. And then one from the Santa Muerte deck. So we're going to have some balance. We're doing the indigenous French Creole. All right. And then we're doing the indigenous Spanish Criollos. So I'm embracing aspects of my ancestors' spirituality and culture. So, all right. So, this is the New Orleans Voodoo Tarot. Get you one. And then the Santo Muerte Tarot. All right. Comes with the book. And he has advice from the dead. But a messenger reads what they read. And then you can explore also what they say in the book it means. Because the person who wrote it, you know, used certain universal symbols that, you know, is like a language. Symbology is a language. But All right, this is a general overall message for my family that's tuned in, the people that fucks with me on my channel and all my social media platforms. Shout out to you. Shout out to you. General message for my viewers. My viewers. All right, one card. We're gonna try to narrow down one card. Cause if y'all wanna read, I got time. And y'all wanna leave a love gift offering for that, then we can go with that. All right, so we have a water spirit and a fire spirit energy. I said one card, but three showed up. All right. Now, Yemaya is a water spirit. It's like the feminine aspect, the mother goddess, a perspective aspect that's personified of the great mother, the source of all things, which is represented by water, the waters of the universe, the oceans, the bodies of water. You also have another Orisha Loa that represents bodies of water, but I pulled Yemaya. So we must continue to nurture our children and our grandchildren, because we living in this age where the revealing has happened. The revelation. So if y'all ever hear me refer to the Bible, that is these key players in the world. This is their playbook, their script. Even though they stole a lot of practical teaching from our ancestors, they put a whole lot of other shit in there too. But you got to know how to read it. You got to read it esoterically. If you read it esoterically, that takes you on a whole nother path. But if you want to read it like thinking it's literal and all this stuff, you're going to be going down a rabbit hole, and it's going to be, on a whole nother level. But this is a nurturing aspect of the Great Mother. And this is a time of revelation, revealing things. The Great Mother, she wants your fucking attention. And Day of the Dead, we pour libations, we pour liquor, we pour water. The Great Mother, creatress of the universe, she wants to be acknowledged. And then she can nurture you to the next level. Because being on Earth, this school called life, we are here to learn lessons, master ourselves, receive knowledge, remember, have wisdom, guidance, and get to that master ascended level. Because even the Jesus character, it was about ascension. To become a master, okay? This is a good book for y'all to get. Return of the Serpents of Wisdom. These people know how to master their chi, their Wakanya yin, their kundalini, their spiritual spark from great mother, great father that is within them. These people have mastered how to use it and to use that power. So, Y'all gotta start acknowledging the great mother. In Christianity, well, in Abrahamic religions, they cut the, basically, they gave the mother the short end of the stick. They said it's the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is really the great mother, the matriarch, the creatress of the universe, the source of all things. Okay, so it's getting back to putting the mother, the nurturer, on a pedestal, because she was knocked off of her pedestal by these patriarchal religions and societies, etc. All right. And then, all right. Now, this is tapping into your personal power, your personal fucking power. You see how she's mounting. She's mounting. She's the one riding and controlling. The other one that I showed y'all earlier, they became one. In essence, they are one, but she's in control. So some people, I'm talking to you out there, you done delved into some shit. Now, even in this free spirituality of our ancestors, it's some shit that the Pink Man Incorporated that you shouldn't even be fucking with. You shouldn't. You should not. You should not. Some things you don't want to fuck with. You want to test it out first. You want to research it first and see if there's balance. Is there balance in that spirituality system? Because if it's not, then it should not be for you. But you have to be, this is Simbi La Flambeau. This is a petrol, a fiery spirit. All right? A fiery, passionate spirit. This is dealing with your personal power and being in control of your personal power. So it's the time to mount up. You don't want your desires and all of that to control you. You want to control your fucking desires. You want to control it. You want to control your personal power. You want to use your personal power to do good things that's going to leave a legacy for your children and your grandchildren and so on and so forth. All right. It's about self-help, self-therapy, mastering self. And then you can ride it. You can be in fucking control. So you got the nurturing aspect of Great Mother, creatress of all things. If you don't have a mother depiction of God, which is God is creatress of all things, if you don't have that in your religion, your spirituality system is not balanced. Okay? So she's showing up. She's saying, I want to nurture y'all. I want y'all to be reborn in the sacred waters, you know, like when a woman is pregnant. You see how she's pregnant? When a woman is, that's the amniotic fluid in the amniotic sac. It nurtures the baby. She wants you to return and be nurtured by her. She wants your fucking respect and acknowledgement. And then she will help nurture you and help you ascend so you can get to this power point in your fucking life, to where you are in control of your desires. Your desires don't fucking rule you. Yeah, flow, have balance. It's a time to be raw and uncut. But you don't want it to fucking control you. You want to be in fucking control. So she's here to help you, help nurture you and you in balance. See, some people is in chaos. Yeah, using some spirituality and culture and magical practices that weren't meant for you. It ain't in your bloodline. It maybe seemed fun to you, or you were misled, misguided. But there's a way for it to be turned around, okay? Because you got help. So this is for those that you went down the wrong path. Went down the wrong path, and your spiritual team is like judging you right now, and they like, hey, it's a judgment call. You gotta tune back into the mother, creatress, the source of all things, so she can give you some guidance and teach you how to be in fucking control. So these are the cards that I got from the Santa Muerte deck. These are relevant. Some of y'all that went too far in those other little practices, y'all had a form, some type of death. Now you got a chance, another chance. You being reborn. You out of that dead state. You sitting up, right? And there is hope. All right. See, you're gonna be reflecting because you learned from your mistakes, and now you can help the other people that's going down that wrong path. You know, you gotta be wise. You gotta be wise, and you gotta have use your discernment. All right. When we linking up with other people that, you know, our ancestors, okay, our ancestors might be from the same tribe. But we also have some of the invaders' blood in our body. And some of y'all have tapped into some of the invaders, their spirituality and culture. And it probably didn't fucking work out for you. But the Great Mother is here in the form of Yemaya, all right? She wants to basically rebirth you. She wants to rebirth you and nurture you so you can be in control. Okay? So you can be in fucking control. So, let me see. Is there anything else? We'll do one more card from this. Because I already had these. I got three cards from that. Yeah, three cards from that. I said one, but hey, I'm flowing with spirit. Right. And I'm doing this on this StreamYard. It's pretty cool. We're gonna see how I do. Because I'm doing a series where I'm gonna be sharing my screen. All right. So the two cards that popped out. Okay. Complimentary. So we got the New Orleans Voodoo Tarot, which deals with the indigenous French Creole. All right. This is the nurturer, the great mother, great mystery creatress in the form of Yemaya, the nurturer. All right. She wants to share her healing waters with you and guide you, nurture you so you can be in fucking control of your own fucking personal power. Now, these cards, all right, this is justice. Some of y'all have been like down the wrong path. Y'all hooked up with the wrong motherfuckers and they was either vampiring your energy, while they were showing you how to tap into these different spiritualities and cultures of your ancestors. But justice is here. I'm here. I represent justice. All right. the Libra. The Libra energy, the justice. All right. And the Queen of Wands is equivalent to this. The Queen of Wands or the King of Wands. Wands represents your personal fucking power. She's in control of her fucking power. She's in control of her fucking power. Even though she has fiery passion, and everybody has something that they are fiery passionate about, and they just love to do that shit. It just comes to them just easy, effortlessly. That's just their gift. That's their talent. That's their power, and they use it. But this is where you have control. It's a time to do things, and it's time to be free and let that shit fucking flow, okay? So, justice. Early depictions of the great mother, creatress, source of all things. Justice flows in with Maat, truth, balance, justice. This is an aspect of the great mother, creatress of all things. So, yeah, Yemaya, the nurturer. The cosmic waters of the black hole, the womb of the universe, and then the amniotic sac, the waters, that's the nurturing, so you can be birthed forth. All right, birth forth, rebirth forth. Like some of y'all went through some shit with your health, and you thought you was dead, but you was in this nurturing aspect. He was in this nurturing incubator type thing. Some of y'all might have been in a coma. You was in a deep state of depression. But now, you sitting up on the side. See, getting up out of there. Sitting on the side. And you about to stand the fuck up so you can be, all right, nurtured, and so you can go forward and be in control of your personal power. You ride the serpent, the dragon. Your desires, you are in control. And that just means the electricity current, how it flows, is in the shape of a snake, a serpent, a dragon. Okay? Also, the Thunderbird and the Phoenix kind of play in that too, but that's a whole nother story. But this is the message. You have the Mother Goddess here to help you, nurture you, guide you, and show you how to be in control of your personal fucking power. So I'm going to end it on that note. I love y'all. If y'all want those spirit astrology readings where we go into your indigenous totems, spirit guides, your different zodiac signs, your different horoscopes, all of that that's dealing with my brand of spirit astrology, or you just want a life path session that is just me being an empathetic listener and I'm giving you spiritual guidance and spirit ancestors guides may have some messages for you, and I'm just the mouthpiece delivering the messages. So that's a life path session. So go to my website or rjxitips.com. I love y'all. Ashe yo, happy Bon Fete, Gede, happy Day of the Dead, Festival of the Dead, happy Dia de los Muertos. I love y'all. Ashe yo, peace.